Engineering Technology Belagavi. So I will be teaching you the third module, that is deflection of beams. So I hope you have already learned the module 1 and module 2. So since the time gap is more, let us just brief about what all the things you have learned in module 1 and module 2. So in module 1 you have learned the classification of structure, so that is 1D, 2D, 3D, and also you have learned what is determinate, indeterminate structure, linear structure, non-linear structure, and also some basics about how to identify degree of static indeterminacy, that is nothing but ds, and degree of kinematic indeterminacy, that is dq, correct? So for beams, for frames, and for trusses, how to find this ds and dq. And also you have learned the analysis of determinate trusses by method of joints and by method of sections in module 1. So in module 2, so you have learnt about some basics about moving loads and influence line diagram, that is ILD. So ILD for concentrated load, for series of concentrated load, UDL longer than the span, UDL shorter than the span. So what will be the effect when you place these loads at a particular point, when you will get maximum bending moment, when you get maximum shear force, absolute bending moment, absolute shear force. So many things you have learnt in ILD, and also the ILD for trusses also you have learnt in module 2. Okay. So let us learn about deflection of beams. So here in this module you will be learning what is deflection. So in association with deflection you will be learning the slope also, so that too with respect to determinate beams, correct? So the determinate structure, when I say a determinate beam, so it will be either simply supported beam or else a cantilever beam, correct? So a determinate structure is one which cannot be, sorry, which can be analyzed with the help of equations of static equilibrium alone. Okay, if you consider a simply supported beam, so it is rested on two simple supports, or else one end is hinged, other end is roller support. So total three reactions you can analyze with the help of three equilibrium equations, sigma h is equal to 0, sigma v equal to 0, and sigma m equal to 0. If you consider a cantilever beam where one end is fixed, other end is free. So at the fixed end there will be three reactions. Again with the help of three equilibrium conditions you can identify what all those three reactions. Okay. In this module, so you will be learning so the deflection and slope at different points due to different loadings. Correct. So here what is deflection and which are the methods to calculate deflection, and what is the necessity of calculating the deflection. Okay, let us go through this PPT and understand one by one. So introduction, so what is deflection? So if you see any structural component, let us say a beam, so this is horizontal, correct? So due to the application of load, so ultimately it will be deflected downwards, correct? That is deviation from its original position. It may not be seen with respect to naked eye, but still there will be slight deviation. That is nothing but deflection. Even the code specifies it has to be within permissible limits only, correct? So if it is more than that, so there are some consequences, correct? So as far as possible, we need to limit according to the codes. That too in particular with mechanical components, where performance of a machine can be calculated. So their deflection calculation is very much essential. Okay, they have to make them within the specified limit only. Okay, so here why to calculate deflection? So these are the points. So to have aesthetic waves, so aesthetic appearance should be there. Then to give psychological comfort to the user. What do you mean by this psychological comfort to the user? So ultimately, when you are sitting, suppose if you assume you are sitting in a room, so there will be beams will be visible, correct? If that particular beam is having some deviation, that is deflection, so which is deflected downwards, if that is the case, do you think you are going to sit in that particular room? So obviously no. So you may think that it is going to fall down, correct? So the psychological comfort of the user should be there, such that the beam should be horizontal only. Correct. That is the psychological comfort of the user. Then to safeguard the flooring materials, windows, frames, etc. So So ultimately, the beam has to be downwards of this particular slab. So slab is resting on the beams. So if you consider the roof, that roof is supporting the flooring materials, that is tiles. Okay, if this particular beam is deflected, so that flooring materials, that is tiles, are going to break, correct? So to safeguard that flooring materials and windows frames, ultimately, so deflection should be calculated. So then last point for analyzing indeterminate beams. So as we discussed, the indeterminate structure, what is that? So a structure which cannot be analyzed with the help of equations of equilibrium alone. So three equations of equilibrium. So when it is not able to analyze with these three equations, then we need to go for some additional equations. Those additional equations are called as compatibility conditions. We can develop these compatibility conditions by slope and deflection to analyze the indeterminate structures. Correct? These are the four points. So you need to know why to calculate deflections. Okay? So which are the different methods to calculate deflection? So first one, if you see, the double integration or Michaelis method. So I hope you already have learnt in strength of material this double integration or Michaelis method. It was there in third semester. So this semester you will be learning moment area method, conjugate beam method, strain energy method, Castiglione's method and unit load method. Okay. So in this module, that is module 3, you will be learning moment area method and conjugate beam method. So in next module, in further modules, you will be learning strain energy method, Castiglione's method and unit load method. So let us start with the first method, that is moment area method. Okay. So what is moment area method? So how we can apply this method to calculate slope and deflection? Okay. So this idea of moment area theorem or method is developed by Otto Mohr in the year 1873, and so later is started by Charles E. Okay. So it is just an alternative method for solving deflection problems. Okay. So in this method, we can establish a procedure that utilizes the area of the moment diagrams. Actually, we will call it as M by ER diagram to evaluate the slope or deflection at selected points along the axis of the beam or frame. Okay. So this moment area method, so it will be using three important terminologies. So those are, one is bending moment, then theorems, that is first theorem, second theorem to calculate slope and deflection, and the correlation between this bending moment diagrams and these theorems and calculation. So for this purpose, we will call this moment area method as semi-graphical method, where it will be using, so bending moment diagrams, a set of diagrams due to the loads, and also it will be using some calculation with respect to theorems, that is theorem 1 and theorem 2. So here the points to remember are, so there are two theorems to calculate slope and deflection, and you should be versatile with respect to drawing of bending moment diagram. You should be knowing, so how the bending moment variation, so with respect to different types of loadings. So if you know what is the bending moment diagram and if you know how to calculate the slope and deflection according to the theorem 1 and theorem 2, so you can easily learn about this moment area method. Okay. So what is moment area method? So once again, this is one of the easiest methods for finding deflection and slope of a beam with the help of area of bending moment of the beam, which is loaded with some load or any moment at any point or in the whole span, correct? So here, scope of the study. So again, this moment area method can be applied to, so that is simply supported beam and it is cantilever beam and also a beam which is indeterminate, both ends fixed. So here if you can see the point one cantilever beams, simply supported beams and beam with fixed end both, sorry, beams fixed at both ends. Okay. So deflection of beams. So which are the assumptions to begin with this moment area method? So these assumptions holds good for moment area method, conjugate beam method, and also the already which you have learnt in double integration method. The same assumptions you need to make it here also. So that is, beam is initially straight and beam is elastically deformed by the loads such that the slope and deflection of the elastic curve are very small. So here you will come across the word elastic curve. What do you mean by elastic curve? This elastic curve is nothing but it is an imaginary curve due to the application of load. How exactly the beam is going to bend? The bent shape assumed due to the load, nothing but elastic curve. If you see a cantilever beam, it is subjected to some type of loading. So here it is fixed due to the load. It may have the deflection like this. Exactly at the fixed support, there will not be any deflection. Even the slope will be zero. If you consider the simply supported beam, due to the application of load, so it may have the deflection like this, a cantilever like this, the simply supported beam like this. This bent shape assumed is nothing but elastic curve. The deformations are caused by bending ultimately. So either it may be a sagging moment is caused to bending, or else it may be a hogging moment, correct? So theorem 1, so as I said earlier, so this moment area method is having two theorems, correct? The theorem number 1 for slope, theorem number 2 for deflection. Let us go through these statements first, then later we can understand these theorems thoroughly. So theorem number 1, so we can read on the statement. The change in slope between any two points on the elastic curve equals the area of the M by ER diagram between two points. So let us read it once again. The change in slope between any two points on the elastic curve equals the area of the M by ER diagram between two points. So you are hearing this M by ER diagram first time, correct? So what is this M by ER diagram? So moment divided by EI, where E is Young's modulus and I is moment of inertia. So M divided by EI, the product of Young's modulus and moment of inertia is called as flexural rigidity. So what you mean by this? So EI is a constant, ultimately a terminology. So it will be varying with respect to different types of beams, correct? So ultimately we are taking any particular structure within the elastic limit, okay? So that is the meaning why we are dividing this M over EI. Okay. So let us come back to this statement. The change in slope between any two points on the elastic curve. So which means to calculate the slope at a particular point, so you should be having two slopes according to this theorem. So where one slope is known, where the unknown slope is unknown. So if you see a cantilever beam, where the slope is zero, so at the fixed end slope is zero, and at the other ends here as it goes on deflecting, the slope is existed. So exactly at the fixed end, so the slope is zero. You can utilize this and also to calculate at different points, okay? So this change in slope between two points is equal to M by ER diagram between two points. That is, if I write in general, theta BA is equal to integration of M over EI into dx. Okay. Let us discuss about these theorems in detail on the board later. Let us look this theorem 2 also. This is the derivation. Again, we can check this. We will come back to this. So, theorem number 2. So, this theorem number 2 is for deflection. So, read on this statement. The vertical deviation of the tangent at a point A on the elastic curve with respect to the tangent extended from another point B equals the moment of the area under the M by ER diagram, it is diagram between these two points A and B. Okay. So this moment is computed about point A where the vertical deviation is to be determined. So again, to calculate the deflection, so that is according to theorem 2, you should be having two tangents and two points. The vertical deviation of the tangent at point A on the elastic curve with respect to tangent extended from another point B that is equal to moment of the area under M by ER diagram. Till now you have heard what is the moment due to a force, correct? So now it is moment of M by ER diagram. Okay, let us discuss this theorem once again. So the statements looks little bit difficult to understand, so we will discuss with the diagram, so it will be easy. So this is theorem number 2. So this is the derivation, we can go ahead with that. So let us come back to the theorem number 1. Okay, according to theorem 1, we will be calculating slope. So in general, slope is denoted with theta. So according to theorem 2, we are calculating deflection. Deflection is generally notated with delta. Okay. So this slope, according to theorem 1. So to just have the proof about that, so let us consider one simply supported beam. Of span L subjected to some type of loading. Okay. So, which type of loading it is? It is general type of loading. Either it is not a UVL, where UVL may be something like this, uniformly varying, 0 at one point and it increases gradually, or else UDL, where the intensity of loading is constant throughout a span. So here we have considered any general type of loading, if that is the case. So I will be taking two points. So let us consider point A and point B. Okay. According to moment area theorem 1, so the change in slope between two points. So I will be having elastic curve. On the elastic curve, point A and point B. So this is simply supported beam. So due to the application of load, the beam may bend like this. This is what? This is elastic curve. The same points on the beam when it is deflected, I have shown over here. So according to theorem 1, the change in slope, to calculate slope, so let us draw a tangent at A, let us draw a tangent at B, DA tangent at A, DB tangent at B. Okay. The change in slope between these two points on the elastic curve, so this is nothing but theta BA. So how to read this angle, theta BA, the tangent at B, the angle made by the tangent at B with respect to tangent at A, it is theta BA. So according to that theorem number 1, it is given by the area between A and B, the moment area between A and B. Okay, let us discuss about this in detail. So to prove that, so let us consider an elemental segment of length dx. So when it is deflected, so here it may be somewhere here, length dx. So don't be under the confusion that here it is straight line, so it is dx. When it is curved, the length may be increasing. No, obviously not. Why? This deflection is very, very, very small. Okay. Through naked eye, you are not going to see anything. Okay. Deflection is very much small. Okay, for that reason, the same thing. If I draw here, this is dx. So when it is deflected, that time also it will be dx only. Though it is having curvature, but the length will be dx since it is very, very small. Correct. So I will consider this element segment and I will draw the exaggerated figure. This is after deflection. So this elastic curve, I will show it here. This is elastic curve. Let us make two points over here. on this beam. A beam, after having the deflection, the elastic curve, this, let us make 2 points. The length is dx only. Okay. On these 2 points on the elastic curve, let us draw the normals. If I extend this, similarly, if I extend this, how to draw this normal? So, normal to the tangent. If I draw a tangent here, it is something like this. If I draw a tangent here, it is something like this. The normal to the tangents, if you extend, they are going to meet at some particular point with respect to some angle. This angle, I will call it as d theta, okay, since it is very, very small. The angle between A and B, it is theta. Since I am considering an elemental strip, so it is very much negligible, d theta. So the same thing, if I make it here, this is tangent at this point, this is tangent at this point, this is theta, so which is very small. The change in slope between this point and this point, the same thing over here. Okay, so you know the equation, that is bending equation in strength of material, already have learnt. So what is that bending equation? M by I is equal to E by R is equal to F by Y. Bending equation, pure bending equation, correct. So I will be using these two. Okay, from these two I can write 1 by R is equal to M over EI, correct. So let us keep this apart. So let us come back to this figure. So what we have done, we have considered 2 points on the beam, so subjected to some type of loading, so it will be deflected, that is elastic curve, the same points on the elastic curve, so after deflecting it will be having the curvature. So this, let us see the radius of curvature R, correct. So this type of sagging movement, correct, the beam is having the deflection, so producing sagging movement. So from this you are aware about how to calculate this length of arc in terms of R and d theta. So what you can write? So the arc length dx is equal to R into d theta, correct. Arc length is given by R into d theta from your calculus, correct. So here this again I will write in terms of 1 by R. So 1 by R is equal to d theta by dx from this. So this is also 1 by R is equal to something. This is also 1 by R is equal to something. If I equate these two equations, what I will be getting? So M over EI is equal to d theta by dx, or else this d theta is equal to M by EI into dx. So let me make this in a square box. Okay. So what I got? D theta is equal to M over EI into dx. So the change in slope between any 2 points on the elastic curve is given by area of M by EI diagram, something like this. So we need to interrelate this first. So what it is saying? So just to interrelate that. Up this. So this, for this beam, if I draw the bending moment diagram, so maybe something like this. Okay, bending moment diagram if I draw it. So this is y axis, this is x axis. On this y axis, this is M. This is, I am considering bending moment diagram. In general, M by EI diagram. Along this is x axis. Okay, that is length of this along x. So this dx length, if I extend the same thing, so this is an elemental strip of length dx. So what is the area of this? So area of this is like a square, sorry, rectangle. So what is the area of this rectangle elemental strip? it is area of this rectangle element strip is height, that is m by er, this is length dx, correct. So area of m by er into dx, so m by er into dx, so this is the area between this and this point. Okay, so what will be the area between A and B? So this I need the area, entire thing between point A and point B. So how to calculate this entire area between point A and point B? I hope you know with respect to calculus. If you are calculating the area between any two points, if I say this is point A, point B, this is a curve. So if you want to calculate the area between under this curve, so what you will be doing? So this is, if I say f of I, so this is f of I is given by integration between point A, point B. So sorry, the area f of I, correct. So similarly, you need to integrate here to calculate area between point A to point B. So the same thing, if I integrate d theta, so that diagram, if you see, so this is for elemental strip. So for A to B, that is theta, correct, between A and B, that is theta A, theta B is equal to integration of m over er into dx between point A to point B. So this is in general can be written as theta B minus theta A is equal to, this is nothing but area of m by ei diagram between A and B. Okay, this is theorem number 1. So what it is saying, the change in slope between any two points, that is point A and point B, on the elastic curve is equal to area of m by er diagram between those two points, correct. So this is theorem number 1. If you want to calculate the slope at any point in a particular beam due to different types of loading, so you should be having two slopes, where one slope is known, where another slope is unknown, if you are calculating. So that is given by area between those two points, which points you have considered here, which points you have selected to calculate the slope, area between those two points, this is the area. If I calculate this, I will be getting the slope, that is the meaning of this. This is theorem number 1 for slope. Similarly, for theorem number 2, so that is for deflection, theorem 2 for deflection, okay. So according to this, if you remember the statement, so let us consider the same simply supported beam subjected to some type of loading having the span L. Let us have two points on the beam, okay. So let us draw the elastic curve, that is deflected shape of the beam. Okay, the same points, two points, point A, point B. According to that statement, the tangential deviation of point A, if I draw tangent at A and tangent B, the tangential deviation of point A with respect to tangent drawn at B means this vertical distance, that is deflection, I can in generally so name it as TAB. First letter indicates where the deflection is required, the second letter from where the tangent is drawn. Okay, TAB. Similarly, if I want to calculate this vertical displacement, I will write it as TBA. What it is indication? The tangential deviation of point B with respect to tangent drawn at A. So the statement, if you remember, the tangential deviation of point A with respect to tangent drawn at B is equal to moment of M by ER diagram. So what is that? Moment of M by ER diagram between point A and point B, and the moment is taken about the point where the deflection is required. That is important. Where to take the moment? You need to take the moment about the point where the deflection is required. So if I am calculating TAB, that is nothing but delta A, if in general, okay, delta A, if I am calculating TAB, so moment has to be taken about point A where the deflection is required. If I am calculating TBA, nothing but delta B, I need to take moment about point B of what? M over EI diagram, area of M by EI diagram into perpendicular distance. In general, what is moment? Force into perpendicular distance. Here, what is the force? Area of M by EI diagram will be the force into perpendicular distance. Okay. So let us just prove this, how we have derived this in the same fashion. So to prove this, what I will be doing, so this elastic curve, I will extend this same element, if I consider dx from point A, let us consider it is at a distance x. What I am doing? Same element I have considered of length dx at a distance x from point A. Okay, if I am calculating TAB, so this element, same here, this is dx. From point A, it is at a distance x. Okay. So if this is the case, let me draw this again, a bigger figure. This is point A, this is point B. So let us consider that element, this element of length dx. So if I draw a tangent from point A, okay, this is the tangent from point A. Similarly, if I draw a tangent at this point here, similarly, if I extend this tangent, is somewhere here, correct? So if I consider this length as dt, or else you can say it as d delta, or else it as dt. Okay. So tangent at this point, tangent at this point, that is element length, and tangent at this point like this, a tangent at this point. So I will be interested in only this. So what is this? This is distance x. So this distance x. So if I exaggerate this figure, this is tangent at this, something like this, this is tangent at this, this is dt. So it is at a distance x in general. The element is here, dx. Since this element is very, very, very small, so I have shown it here. This x, I will be considering it as entire thing. So since it is very small, when you draw a tangent, so instead of this dx, let us consider this entire thing. So this and this both are x only. Since the deflection is small, even element length is small, so this dt, if this is dt, the angle subtended over here, it is d theta. Similarly, for this, how you extended, the same thing in the fashion, if you extend like this, this is d theta, again r, for that elemental length, if you extend, okay, for elemental length, if you extend, so this is d theta, again this is r, okay. So here one curvature, here one more curvature. If I write this, the arc length dt is equal to this x into d theta. So here dx, this is dx, dx is equal to r into d theta. Okay. So from these two, so what is d theta? So d theta is nothing but, so here dt divided by x, here dx divided by r. So again from bending equation, it is, let it be m by I is equal to E by R. So what is 1 by R is equal to m by ER. So here if I substitute, what I will be getting? So I will be getting, so 1 by R is equal to d theta by dx. If I compare this and this, I will be getting what? So d theta equal to m by EI into dx, correct? So from these two, what I have done? So once again, let me explain. So what we have considered? So the beam, two points, and elemental segment. So the elemental segment is at a distance x from point A. So this is the elastic curve. I have drawn a tangent from here, the tangent from here, the deviation of this tangent, it is dt, okay. From this tangent to this tangent, the deviation is dt. So the same thing, this tangent, deviation is dt. Since the deflection is very small, the element length is very small, so I have considered this entire thing as x from O. So this was the element. So from theorem 1, in the same fashion, if I write the arc lengths, I will be getting dt is equal to x into d theta, dx is equal to r into d theta. So from bending equation, I will be getting this. So then again, if I equate these two, d theta equal to m by ei into dx, correct? So if this is the case, so here, what is d theta? According to this, d theta is equal to dt divided by x. See, so this is one equation, this is one equation. If I equate these two, so what I will be getting? This equation and this equation, m over ei into dx is equal to dt into x. Okay. So if I make it still better, m over ei into dx, if I take this x this side, into x is equal to dt. So what is this dt? Dt is nothing but deviation of this point from this point. So elemental length we have considered, deviation of this tangent to this tangent. So according to theorem 2. So if you integrate within the limits, that is a to b, so you will be getting, so here a to b, you will be getting the second theorem. So what is that? So this, if I integrate within a b, t a b is equal to the integration, nothing but a to b m by ei into dx, nothing but it is area into x. What is this? Perpendicular distance. About what? About a point. Correct? I hope it is clear. So in general, if I want to write TAB is equal to delta is equal to moment of by ear diagram between A and B, and movement is taken about A, where the deflection is required. This is delta A. Okay. So these are the two theorems. This is theorem 1, this is theorem 2. I hope it is clear. So the theorem 1, so you need to remember ultimately these expressions. So theta B minus theta A, the change in two slopes, okay, must be equal to area of M by A diagram over. So M by A diagram, you need to calculate the area, you will get the slope. For second theorem, deflection, the deflection at point A, that is moment of M by A diagram about A, moment is about A. If I am calculating delta B, moment of M by A diagram about moment is about B. Okay, then that time I will write it as T B A. Okay, so this is theorem 1, this is theorem 2. So we will be using these two theorems to calculate slope and deflection. So for cantilever beam and simply supported beam subjected to different types of loadings, okay, at any particular point. Okay. Let me solve one simple problem, okay, with respect to cantilever beam. Let us solve the problems with respect to cantilever beam first, then we can go with simply supported beam. So we can apply these two theorems and let us solve one simple problem to calculate slope and deflection for cantilever beam. Okay, let me consider a cantilever beam where one end is fixed, other end is. So let us consider a point load W at the free end. So let us consider this is point A, this is point B, this span is L. Okay. So in this, let us calculate what is delta B and what is theta. So what is delta B? Deflection at point B. What is theta A? What is slope at B, deflection at B, slope at B. So you know this, correct? Cantilever beam, here exactly at this point slope will be 0 at fixed end because there is no deflection, even the slope is 0. Okay. What you know, theta A is 0. Okay. So if I draw the elastic curve from point A to point B, so it may be something like this, correct? So this is a cantilever beam at the free end, a concentrated load is applied. Okay, so here it is entirely fixed, here the load is applied. If you apply load, it may have the deflection. So exactly here slope will be 0. Okay, so if I draw a tangent at this point, because according to theorem 1, what it is, the change in slope between two points. So how to calculate slope? You need to draw the tangents. Let us consider the point A. If I draw a tangent, it is horizontal. This is horizontal, exactly, where slope is 0. And if I draw a tangent at B, so it may be something like this. So what you are calculating? The change in slope between these two points, theta B A. Okay. So this is what? This is elastic curve. Due to the application of load, it may have the deflection like this. It is an bent shape assumed. So I have drawn a tangent at A, which is horizontal, so theta A is 0. I have drawn a tangent at B, so it may be something here, they are meeting. So this is the change in slope between two points. You need to calculate this. And one more, you need to calculate delta B. What is that? the deviation of point B with respect to tangent drawn at A. What is the tangent at A? The tangent at A is here only, from the tangent at B. So this is delta B. So or else you can write it as TBA. What is this TBA? Tangential deviation of point B with respect to tangent drawn at A. This is the point B, this is the tangent at A. Correct? How to calculate this? According to theorem 1. What is theorem 1? So the change in slope between two points, theta B minus theta A. So theta A is 0, which is known, it is 0. Theta B, this you are calculating, theta B minus theta A is equal to what it is? Area of M over EI diagram between A and B. Between A and B. So M over EI. So you need to first draw the bending moment diagram for this cantilever beam. How it will be? So exactly at this point, I hope you know it. So from this, the effect of moment goes on, increases towards the fixed end. Exactly at the free end, moment will be 0. So what is moment? Force into perpendicular distance. Exactly at this point, moment is 0. As we go near to this, the fixed end, moment goes on, increases. Okay? If it is simple support, moment is 0 because it is free to rotate. If it is roller support, it is free to rotate. If it is in support, it is free to rotate. Okay? They cannot resist the moment. They are freely rotated. But it is fixed support, it is resisting the moment. If it is resisting the moment, their moment exits. Okay? So here, free to move. Here, it is fully fixed. It is not allowing to move. Means moment exits over there. So from here to here, as you go near, moment goes on, increases. Correct? If that is the case, how the diagram will be? So here point B, 0. So here point A. Correct? At A, moment. So force into perpendicular distance. Concentrated load, a linear variation. Correct? W into L. So from here to here, a linear variation and moment. This is W into L. Okay? This is L. So we want M by EI diagram. So it is WL by EI. Here they have not mentioned the flexure rigidity, whether it is varying. So if they have not given anything, so we need to consider it as constant. Moment is W into L by EI, W over WL divided by EI. Okay. So according to theorem 1, theta B minus theta A is equal to area of M by EI diagram between A and B. This is the bending moment diagram, that is M over EI diagram between A and B. Okay, what is the area of this? So it is a triangle. Correct? It is a triangle. What is the area of triangle? Half into base into height, WL by EI. So nothing but half WL square by EI. Okay, in general, WL square by 2EI. Correct? W into L into L, half into base into height. This is the height, this is base. So here is half into base into height. WL square by 2EI. Okay? So whether it is plus or minus. So bending moment diagram is negative or positive. So sign convention you are aware. So when you consider a beam, when you cut a section from rightwards, if it is anti-clockwise positive, from leftwards, if it is clockwise positive. This is the sign convention. Now here you are taking moment, you are cutting a section here, means you are taking moment here, the load is here, so you need to fix it here, the apply load, so it may have the reflection, sorry, moment clockwise. Correct? Cut a section rightwards, if it is anti-clockwise, then it's positive. But here this is making clockwise, means opposite to this, it is negative. this is negative diagram. Okay, so if this is negative, this is negative, this is negative, this is negative. So theta b is minus w l square by 2 e i. Okay, this is slope. If I want to calculate the deflection, that is according to theorem 2. What is that? What you are calculating? Delta b TBA, or else delta b is equal to what? Moment of m by er diagram between A and V, and moment is taken about point B, where the equation is required. Moment of m by er diagram between A and B, and it is about point B. So what is moment of m by er diagram? Correct. So area, you know it. So this m by er diagram between A and B, nothing but half into base into height, area into perpendicular distance, where the CG will be here. From here to here, moment is about B, where the deflection is required about that point. So what is this? So from minimum position it is 2/3 of L, from maximum position it is 1/3 of L. Correct. CG, center of gravity, you know it. Okay, from this point, about point B we want, this distance is 2/3 of L. So I can write this, this diagram is negative. Area of m by er diagram, what is that? This whole diagram is acting like a load. This is force, force into perpendicular distance, that is moment. Here force is area of this diagram, half into base into height, wl by ei into perpendicular distance, this is force, area of this diagram, perpendicular distance about v, 2/3 of l. So if I calculate this, 2, how much are getting? WL cube by 3EI. This is delta B. So slope is WL square by 2EI. Deflection is WL cube by 3EI. So always remember, for cantilever beam, due to different types of loading, usually other than it is subjected to external movements, whether clockwise or anticlockwise. So usually the bending moment diagram will be always negative, and you will be getting slope and deflection negative. Okay, so let us stop it here. So in next class we will continue with different types of problems due to different types of loadings.